Download Tarang online radio app from Google Play Store.
Next generation. Let me come back to this responsibility. We are indeed privileged that Sri Justice Vellayan Sathasivam, Honorable Governor of Kerala, is with us, asking us at this function. The Honorable Governor is a great sports enthusiast. He has always been gracious to accept our invitation to important functions hosted by SAI NLCP. Sir, I, on behalf of SAI NLCP family, all those who are assembled here, and on my own behalf, I offer you a very warm and respectful welcome to our meeting. I also welcome Madam, the First Lady, also who has been gracious enough to welcome Madam. We have the Honorable Minister for Cooperation, Tourism, Devasam Government of Kerala, Sri Kadakampalli Surendran. Is a true friend and guide of this institution. Sir has always been helpful in guiding us in all that we require for achieving excellence in sports. Sir, with great pleasure, I welcome you most heartily to this function. We have a witness, Dr. A. Jethilan, Principal Secretary to Sports and Interface Government of Kerala, spearheading the Sports and Interface Department of the state. Being a medical graduate, he has taken keen interest. The very soon he has taken over in learning the subject deep and finding out strategies to uplift the standard of the sports industry and the country. I am on behalf of Sports Authority of India, NLCP, on behalf of all those who are present here, and on my personal behalf, welcome to you, sir. We have Dr. Devendra Kumar Godawar, Secretary to Honorable Governor, the Ministers. He has been a source of great inspiration and guidance, also a keen sports enthusiast, a regular participant in fitness activity. May I, on behalf of Sports Board of India, NLCP, on behalf of all those who are present here and on my personal behalf, welcome Sri Dr. Devendra Kumar Godawar, Secretary to Honorable Governor to our Minister. Welcome to you, sir. We have Dr. Sanjay Kumar, IFS Secretary of Kerala State Sports Council. He's a family member, had been a part of all our important locations and functions, and had been very helpful for the institution. I, on behalf of SAI NLCP, on behalf of all my colleagues and on my personal behalf, welcome you, sir, to our meeting. We have Dr. M. N. Krishnamurthy, the former Director General of Police, to a close friend of this institution, had been a source of great inspiration and guiding us in various matters. On behalf of all those who are present here, on behalf of the institution and on my personal behalf, welcome you, sir, to our meeting. We have Dr. P. S. M. Chandran, the former Director of Sports Authority of India Sports Medicine Unit of SAI Headquarters, and also the President of Indian Sports Medicine Association. He is one of the tallest figure in the field of sports science, being kind enough to accept our invitation to be a minister from this occasion. I welcome you, sir, to our minister. We have also many eminent speakers and ministers who have been kind enough to accept our invitation. Arjuna Bodies, who have the winners of the Asian Games, which has been recently concluded, brought laurels to the country. They will be all felicitated separately, and they are all assembled here. I welcome all the eminent guests and our sports stars, all to our midst, and we'll be waiting for each one of you to come over and sit and to be felicitated here. Welcome all of you. I also welcome all the other dignitaries on and off the dais, all the friends from the media, all my colleagues, all the faculty members, trainees, and ladies and gentlemen, all those who have come here to grace this occasion. Welcome, one and all. Thank you very much.
Inaugural address, Sri Justice Retired P. Sathasivam, Honorable Governor, Kerala State.
Sri Kadakampalli Surendran, Honorable Minister for Cooperation, Tourism and Devasam. Sri Sanjayan Kumar, IFS, Director, Department of Sports and Youth Affairs. Dr. M. N. Krishnamurthy, former DGP, Dr. Devendra Kumar Dodavar, Principal Secretary to Governor, Dr. P. S. M. Chandran, President, Indian Federation of Sports Medicine, Dr. A. Jayatilak, IAS, Secretary Sports, Dr. G. Kishore, Principal, Sports Authority of India, Lakshmibai National College of Physical Education, Dr. Usha S. Nair, Academic in Charge, Sports Authority of India, Lakshmibai National College of Physical Education, respected teachers, my dear students, elite athletes, eminent sports persons, friends from media, Sahodari Sahodaran Mare, Ellavarkum Ende Namaskaram. It gives me great joy to inaugurate the seminar entitled Health Real Wealth, that is Swachh Bharat, Swasth Bharat, organized to commemorate the birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, the father of our nation, at the campus of Sports Authority of India, Lakshmibai National College of Physical Education, Thiruvananthapuram. Let me begin by complimenting Dr. Kishore, Principal and Staff of the Lakshmibai National College of Physical Education, for organizing this seminar. This is indeed befitting start to the celebration of our beloved Babu's 150th birth anniversary. I am happy that this program has the presence of outstanding athletes who participated in the recently concluded 18th Asian Games at Indonesia. Let me congratulate them on their stellar performance. As all of us know, our Honorable Prime Minister had made a promise when he assumed office in 2014 that by 2019, when we celebrate the 150th birth anniversary of Gandhiji, India would have become one of the cleanest nations in the world. Needless to say, we are aiming at a healthier India through clean and green India. Many years ago, Gandhiji had made this concept of health very clear in his ever relevant saying that health is real wealth and not pieces of gold and silver. I'm happy that this institution, through its daily activities, adhere to this Gandhian dictum by capturing the spirit of his saying in physical fitness, nutrition and cleanliness. While we talk of the importance of healthy living, we cannot ignore the fact that history has witnessed many epidemics which have wiped out large sections of the world population. We also cannot forget how abject poverty has created ill health by compelling people to live in unclean surroundings that expose them to various diseases. Poverty has also killed thousands in many countries where people struggle without proper shelter, clean water or sanitation. It is therefore not surprising that the sustainable development goals adapted by the global community for the period 2016-2030 have listed eradication of poverty and hunger and ensuring of good health as top targets. While global efforts to ensure health are in progress, we almost do our bit. For this, we should recall Mahatma Gandhiji's warning about economic impact of the lack of sanitation. While Swachh Bharat Abhiyan has been able to usher in some change in our concept of cleanliness, we still need to be worried by some statistics. For example, estimates say that India lost $237 billion between 2006 and 2015 from premature deaths due to heart disease, stroke, and diabetes. India has also had to spend nearly 10% of its gross domestic product on handling non-communicable diseases. All these point to the need to adhere to a healthy lifestyle. When we follow a healthy lifestyle, we are empowering ourselves socially and economically. But more than that, we will also be contributing to the economic stability of our nation in our own way. You may aware that the health policy of the government of Kerala lays great emphasis on activities which would encourage people to use for avenues for games and exercise. Here it is worthwhile to recall Mahatma Gandhi's account of how, as a student in London in early 1890s, he used to walk about 8 miles every day. In fact, he also had another walk in the evening at 5:30 p.m. for an hour, and then for 30 to 45 minutes before going to bed. This and the strict diet are believed to be secret behind the good health he enjoyed. This is an example all of us could follow. Here I think it will not be out of place to recount my personal experience at Rajbhavan. Every day, whenever I am available at Rajbhavan, go for an hour's walk in the morning and in the evening. This gives me a bit of exercise and enables me to recall my earlier days in an agricultural background. It is said that active farmers do not need any sporting activity, themselves physically fit, because their work involves physical labor. But people like me need to walk or run to ensure fitness. During my walk, I can personally verify the daily progress of the plants and trees we have planted at Rajbhavan campus in the last 4 years. Most people in Rajbhavan say that I am perhaps the first governor to have seen every nook and corner of that campus. Stopping for a moment, maybe 1 year back, Dr. Kishore came with many of our friends sitting here or might have completed the course to plant more trees in the Rajbhavan campus. Then after interacting with the students for some time, I conveyed a message after my entry, even before that. Rajbhavan always being kept very clean, and we had fortunately very good trees, and every governor occupying the Rajbhavan, they also planted many trees and improved the entire area. Since no place to clean in our Rajbhavan, I requested them to plant good trees, some good fruit bearing trees. And I mentioned earlier, every day whenever I am available at Rajbhavan, morning and evening, go through the entire garden, including the medicinal garden we planted 1 year back with the assistance of the central government and medicinal board. And because of my personal supervision, all the plants are coming up. I am proud to inform the August gathering, before our natural calamity, Honorable President of India along with the First Lady, we stayed 2 days in our Rajbhavan at Thiruvananthapuram, and I took our Honorable President to the entire Rajbhavan, 29 acres. He spent more than half an hour verifying the medicinal plants. We planted medicinal plants in 2 acres. Then at the end of the garden, he said, Sir, Governor, when you visit Delhi, please come to Rashtrapati Bhavan. I have, at my instance, planted medicinal plants in 6 acres in Rashtrapati Bhavan. Please come and have a look so that you will also expand. So that is the appreciation and request made by our Honorable President. But ours is a small area, only 29 acres, that is sufficient. And why I am mentioning, because today's topic, cleanliness is more important. We have to keep our premises clean. I used to visit my officers' quarters. Every time I used to advise, you have to keep minimum at least 5 to 7 feet in and around your house clean. And thanks to the state government, every year they are supplying good seeds to each one. Each person is eligible one packet of seeds containing vegetables, particularly well in advance of Onam festival. So we distribute these seeds to our staff members, and I am personally verifying whether at least someone get vegetables in return. I would suggest that artists, office goers, businessmen should make a garden around their house and regularly work at least half an hour there. They can also remember Gandhiji's advice that for a person engaged in intellectual work, doing a bit of physical work every day will serve to improve even the quality of his intellectual output. If that work is done in a clean and unpolluted environment, it will boost your health considerably. Before winding up, because all of you are students in sports college, I want to inform one incident. Most of you might have seen in the television channel. I noticed suddenly, as per the news report and news channel, suddenly one day our Honorable Prime Minister, without notice to security people, you know how he is eligible, he has to be protected. but without intimation to police, his car coming out of his official residence with a small group of persons, not the usual conclave or carcade. Suddenly he entered a school with no notice. That school, even the gatekeeper reluctant to open a gate because no intimation to them. Suddenly he car entered, he got down from the car, he went round the entire school, compound school area, and I noticed in a bare hands, we use gloves and do several things, but bare hand he collected all waste papers in the school ground and school areas and put it in a basket. He spent half an hour. Then at that time, then principal and other students also joined. Then after spending some time with them, he left. Now why I am mentioning, it is a message to everyone. When such a person having more busyness and in such a busy schedule, spend some time to keep our premises clean, why not be? Only for that I mentioned this. I have just mentioned some of my thoughts behind my firm belief that health is the greatest wealth. I am happy that today's seminar intends to create awareness among the upcoming the SAI trainees to become part of the cleanliness drive of the nation for a better training environment, which would certainly lead to the better health. I greet all the eminent sports fraternity, including Arjuna and Dronacharya awardees. Actually, during the Asian game, I spent more time in the new channel. I was anxious to see more Keralites. I am fortunate at least few of you are here. In the next Asian Games, I expect whether I am going to be here or not, that is immaterial. More Keralites have to. In All India level, I am aware, though I come from a judicial side, in All India level, almost in sports except cricket, in all other activities, Keralites, particularly in athletes, Keralites get high position. So I pray for more medals for this state in the next Asian Games. The Arjuna and Dronacharya awardees, trainees, students, coaches, teaching faculty, administrative staff, parents of the trainees attending this program, and all those who presented the fitness program here. I also compliment the principal and students of Sports Authority of India, Lakshmibai National College of Physical Education, for conducting this function in a befitting manner. Ellavarkum ende aashamsakal, nanni, jai hind.
Honorable Governor, Lady Governor, Madam, Sri Kadangapalli Surendran Sir, Dr. A. Jayatilak Sir, Dr. A. Sampath Sir, Dr. Devendra Kumar Sir, Dr. Sanjayan Sir, Dr. M. N. Krishnamurti Sir, Dr. P. S. M. Chandran Sir, Dr. G. Kishore. Our invited guests, the awardees, and my dear friends, we are extremely grateful to have with us Honorable Governor Sir and Madam for your valuable presence. So your presence and blessings will certainly boost the mind of youth and the sportsmen and all these stakeholders, since you believe in Swachhata. And sir is the one who just not just preach but practice too. Sir clearly stated, since we talk of Swachhata today, from the fitness perspective, it's all cleanliness, and we find sir practicing it, being physically fit, getting into walks, and also his beautiful garden for which the president has appreciated. I think it's a lesson for us, sir. Your presence here is a blessing for us. Hats off to you, sir, and thank you so much because you were so kind to us, where you readily agreed upon to be the guest of honor for our program, that is Swachhata. And with this, in a year's time, definitely you'll find a change. By 2019, this campus itself you'll be finding, will be redefining in terms of Swachhata. Thank you so much, sir. And I would like to tell, madam, you are the mother. Your stepping in has blessed us. We are indebted to you, and thank you so much for being a part of us. Shri Kadangapalli Surendra sir, you've been always supportive, and we are indeed indebted and grateful for the valuable presence and the speed that sir has done. And I'm sure whatever we ask for, sir is always ready, and sir's support is going to help us to boost this institution to greater heights. Thank you so much, sir. Dr. A. Jayatilak, sir, Principal Secretary of Sports. I think since yesterday, sir was on this campus, and the campus was gearing up. Sir, with you taking in this, I'm sure LMCP would again attain heights, because there are a number of things which we need, and you're there to always help us. And we look forward to your support. Thank you so much, sir. Dr. Devendra Kumar, sir, we had been at the governor's place. A person who's so simple, who's so supportive, and is also keen in fitness. And it's because of sir that we could have this program and a guest with us. Thank you so much, sir. Dr. Sanjayan, sir, who's a very close friend of this institute, and often we look forward to Kerala Sports Council for any help, and always we get help as soon as we ask for. Thank you so much, sir, for all this support. Dr. M.N. Krishnamurthy, sir, your valuable presence, who has come all the way from Bangalore to attend this conference to create an awareness on Swachhata. Sir, thank you so much for coming all the way and guiding our children. Dr. P.S.N. Chandran, sir, who is again the president, a very eminent person, who has from Delhi, come all the way from Delhi to be a part of this program. Thank you so much, sir. And our principal, Dr. J. Kishore, who is the spearheading this institution, and what we see today is because of him. I'd also like to put forth on this occasion that this college is no less than any other institute in the country, one of the best in the country. And this podium, I think it's so much of weight with governor and the medalist and the coaches and Dronacharya awardees and the probable list who are here. I think it's really a weighted place today. So indeed we are blessed, and we look forward that this very soon will turn out to become a university, so that I'm sure there'll be much more scope for this. I'd like to thank all the invited guests, and especially the medalist who toiled, worked so hard, but you brought laurels not only for the state but for the country. And we are indeed, LNCP and simply proud of you. We are proud of you for having, and especially the players and the coach. I think we have been seeing here, I think they just 24 hours, they don't have a family. They have got married to the particular sport. I think hats off to the coaches and the athletes. I am sure all those sitting over here, we should have more number of medalists, and I'm sure Kerala would be proud, India would be proud of you. I'm thankful to all the trainees, but the organizers who have been working day and night for this beautiful stage. I think we have Matthew Lucas, sir, and his team, a wonderful job for this particular stage. untiring effort by the NIS trainees, LNCP students and all those who have helped to make this a grand success. For the reception, we have Dr. Shailaja, we had Shri Najibuddin, and we had a number of people whom I may not be able to mention each one, Dr. Shri Pranjit Lal. I think there were a lot of people who were entirely working. And I'd like to tell the display group, it was a wonderful, superb performance that you've done here today. And I'm sure that a message will be carried across that our children are not only good, dance as well as movement is something which is in them. In the end, if I missed out, I'm extremely sorry. I thank one and all present here. Thank you so much.